Somewhere in the Rift of Cinders, Vesnon has escaped from the hellish depths of Pandemonium, and now he is looking forward to a nice bath in his Dark Tower. But to Vesnon's surprise, his Dark Tower turned into a carnival. Time to take back what is his and to start his journey to take over Lineria. Since the hideous dwarven machines have deforested his beautiful dead forest, Vesnon targeted them first. Of course, Vesnon can't take over Lineria by himself. He formed a league of villains and reformed the Dark Army that he once owned. And so, they raided the Dwarven Gates and made their way through the Kazan Mines until they eventually reached Bolger's throne. Vesnon demanded the throne, and Barisad wanted the gold that Bolger owns, as Vesnon promised the gold that they will be getting from the Dwarven Kingdom. With that, the Dwarven Kingdom stood no chance, and their resources are now at Vesnon's disposal. They made their way to the Frozen North to face the so-called King of the North. When the Dark Army arrived at the Northerner's outpost, the Northerners had the chance to blow the horn to warn the others in the village, and that made Vesnon mad, as they now need to act faster to march down the Frozen Rapids and to take control of the village. When they arrived in the village, the Dark Army was able to track down the King of the North, but unfortunately, he fled via his dragon to the mountaintops. On the bright side, the King of the North is cornered on the mountain like a rat, but he won't come down for a fight. He got his horn and started blowing it to awaken Jokul. Vesnon, of course, has the tools to kill Jokul, as he has two cannons to take Jokul down, and he did, making the mountain his new real estate to view Lineria. From the mountaintops to the ignorant farms of Otel, the pesky farmer stood no chance, making Vesnon advance into the Silver Oak outpost to capture Illyria, which he did. Then comes Magnus, Vesnon's old apprentice. The Dark Army needs to take down Magnus as he has casted a barrier around the castle of Dennis. Vesnon, of course, defeated his puny apprentice, and Magnus begged to bargain, but Vesnon begged to differ as he captured him in his shackles. With two down, one to go, Gerald seems rather calm in his camp. What a fool to think that he is the one-man army and that he can handle the Dark Army single-handedly. Overconfidence leads to Gerald's defeat. Then, the final face-off of once two great friends broke loose in the castle. Puny stone bricks will not stop Vesnon as he broke it and made Dennis retreat to the inside of the castle. Vesnon had a trick up his sleeve, and that is summoning a demon, but Dennis had a trick as well. The final battle for the kingdom between Vesnon and Dennis has come to an end, with the finishing punch of the Archdemon. Paragon stood down in defeat. Dennis locked his doors, but puny padlocks won't stop Vesnon. The padlock was destroyed by the demon, making Vesnon knock at the door. Vesnon and Dennis talked for one last time before Vesnon banished Dennis in a portal. With Dennis gone, Vesnon is the new king and ruler of the lands of Lineria. Somewhere in the depths of the castle, Vesnon confronted a giant eye-looking thing, and from there, the true battle begins. But this true battle can't begin just yet, as Oriens have made a return to the land, and they thought that they can take what Vesnon owns. Vesnon sought help from the Deep Devils for a chance of redemption. This redemption was made, as Pollux had no chance of survival from Vesnon's army. Then the reports say that the ancient Winter Queen broke free from her icy prison. Vesnan took action, and the Dark Army headed into the mountains to stop her, which they did. The moment then came wherein Vesnan had to fulfill his part of the bargain with the two ghosts, but Vesnan refuses to pay, as the claims of the ghosts were too high. So instead of paying, Vesnan weakened the ghosts, then he locked the ghosts up for good. Hmm.